Hello and welcome to my new video. Today I want to show you how to buy the cryptocurrency BNB. First of all, of course, we need a trading provider. For that I would recommend Binance. Binance is currently by far the most popular and cheapest trading provider on the market. This confirms the ranking of CoinMarketCap, as the trading volume is almost 10 times higher than the daily trading volume as second place. This mainly because Binance has a ridiculous cheap fee of 0.1% and offers the largest selection of cryptocurrency with the latest prices. If you do not have an account on Binance yet, or you are already registered but not yet verified, or you are already trading on Binance but have not yet created a futures account, you can still register with my link, first link in the video description, and save 10% on your trading fees for a lifetime, or you can just use the code shown here. When you have completed the registration process, you should verify yourself in order to be able to act without restrictions. All you need is a picture of your passport or identity card. You will also be asked for an address verification. This is completed within minutes. Then you can get started. And as I said, if you haven't done this step yet, but are you already registered, you can still secure the 10% bonus at any time via my link in my video description. If you're done with the verification part, of course the first question that arises is how we can trade now. For that we first have to deposit our money on our fiat or spot wallet. It should be said that your wallets are divided into three different areas. To do this, we see the wallets button up here. There you will find the option to choose overview to get an overview of all your wallets at a glance. In the fiat and the spot areas you can deposit or withdraw any cryptocurrency, or of course deposit euro or dollar or something similar in the normal way via, for example, SEPA transfer. This is of course also across trading platforms. That's why we take a closer look at the fiat and spot area to clarify the basic things about how to deposit and withdraw money. But it also should be said that there is still the margin area as well as the futures area, which maybe one or the other knows from other trading providers, which have a ladder function of up to 125. If you go into the wallet, fiat and spot, you can find the button deposit up here. If we click on it, we can already see that the deposit is divided into two areas. There is once the option of paying in by fiat with dollars, euros and other main currencies. Here you could pay in via SEPA transfer. This doesn't cost any fees and usually happens within a few seconds to a maximum of 10 minutes. In principle, it is just as fast as a PayPal deposit. You just have to make sure that you click on the real-time transfer box at your online banking provider. When making the transfer, this doesn't cost you any cent more. Even on Sundays, your deposit will be processed within seconds. Even after 5 PM, all through, Binance keeps pointing out that a transaction after 5 PM may not be proceed until the next working day. However, this is more a guaranteed period, not the actual real one. If you want to deposit with cryptocurrencies, you can of course simply choose the crypto option instead of the fiat variant. But we also should note that there are different deposit networks. Like Bitcoin has a different deposit network to Ethereum. You can see this over here. A QR code or a deposit address will be generated there, which you can copy as you wish. The same applies of course to the payout area, which you can also find right here next to the deposit button. The same applies here, you can pay out your desired fiat currencies once. This also usually happens within a few seconds to a maximum of 10 minutes. Or if you want to have your cryptocurrencies paid out or want to send them across trading platforms, you can of course do this as you wish. You just have to enter the correct address over here. Make sure that you choose the right wallet to receive for the respective cryptocurrency. There are also different transfer networks. Here I would always choose the Binance networks, as this usually only costs a few cents. Then you just have to select your desired amount below, correct and make sure that everything is right, and then you can send your coins. So, when we have now received our paid in money, the question naturally arises, has to be, how can we trade, how can we continue? First of all, you should think about what you even want to do at all. There are a number of ways to do things at Binance. Via the first link that you can find below, you can secure yourself another 10% commission discount. If you now have money on your Binance account, you can just go to the Binance start page where you will find the popular cryptocurrencies and the button View More Markets. There, you just click on it to get to the selection for every available cryptocurrency. First of all, we can already see that every coin has a slash behind it. This indicates with which currency we can buy or sell the desired cryptocurrency. As we can see here, we can only trade our coins with BNB. That's because we are still in the BNB market area up here. If we change the area, we will see that we can also buy and sell with other currencies. On my personal favorite area, the fiat market, where you can use the most popular currency, USDT, also called Tether, as you wish. There you will also be offered levels up to 10. If you didn't know about the Binance Future section already, there you can use a leverage up to 125. If you want to buy USDT or Ethereum in order to be able to buy your desired cryptocurrency, I would recommend you to choose either Convert here or both, where you can convert any currency into another. But this does apply a small fee. So I would recommend and prefer you to click on Buy Crypto at the top left and select the Cash Balance section, from where you can buy any cryptocurrency such as USDT or Ethereum for free, or with a fee of maximum of 0.1%. So you could buy the desired currency with your deposit, euro or dollar, from your cash balance, with which we can now buy the original desired cryptocurrency that you wanted. If you have the required currency already, as in my case USDT, we can go back to the main menu of Binance and click on View More Markets, as we did already. Here you can enter and search for the cryptocurrency you want, as already explained at the beginning. If you don't find them, you should change your market up here. In my case, I just entered the currency DENT. As you can see, I could buy DENT in the respective markets for different currencies. A certain cryptocurrency is not necessarily required for every currency. Some can also be paid for with euros or the like. In my case, I have now decided on the currency DENT in order to be able to buy it normally, in order to be able to sell it at any time. I will find it on the fiat market, because I want to pay with USDT. Because USDT, also called Tether, as I said, is the most stable of most currencies. If you want to use a leverage of up to 125, you should go to the futures area. More on that when different. To buy DENT, as in my case, we simply click on trade here. Then we see the usual view with our nice overview of the candles. We can of course adjust our beautiful chart at any time. For this I usually always use a 1 minute timeline to always be up to date. Here on the right you can see the order books, including on the one hand the people where the positions want to sell or who want the price to fall. Below that we can see the long order book with all orders for the price increase. But don't let that confuse you, because underneath there is the right window again, where you can see which trades are actually being closed and not just the orders. In order to be able to trade ourselves, we can already see the overview, limit and market on the right. Limit means, as the name suggests, that we can create and order at our desired entered price. And over here, there is still the market purchase, direct trade, not an order, but at the bloody market price. The bar below is for how much you want to deposit or sell. In which case, as I said, the currency USDT is used in your case. In your case, that could be Bitcoin, Binance Coin, Ethereum or something like that. If you're wondering where your coins have gone, as already mentioned, there are various wallets on Binance. If you are currently in the futures sector and want to trade there but have no money or through, you have just paid in, you must first transfer the money from your fiat and spot wallet to your futures wallet. To do this, you can select the transfer button next to the deposit button in the fiat and spot wallet. It should be said that you can send your money from wallet to wallet at any time without incurring costs. This usually happens within seconds. This difference, wallets are there as customer protection, because you can use the lever up to 125 times in the Binance Futures area, and your liquidation price is extended until your entire futures wallet is empty if no stop loss is set. That's why you should definitely always secure the most money on your spot and fiat wallet if you dare to use such large leverage in the futures area, in order to avoid losing everything that has been paid up in any case. So if you now create an order or a trade, we can do that here. We see a window below where it pops up, either for positions or for orders, depending on what you've done, or both. Then we see the window of our position here. A lot of people don't know how to close this position. We can simply click the Close All Positions button up here, or we simply click the Market button here to sell directly for the market price, or you enter your stop loss or take profit here so that this trade will be sold at the set price. In the order history, trading history or transaction history, we can see exactly how much profit we have made, how much fees we have paid, and much more. In the futures area of Binance, there is still the speciality between quarterly and perpetual. This simply means that you should hold the position at quarterly for a certain period of time, as in this case we are shown until the end of March. And in the perpetual area, it is so that we could liquidate our desired position at any time without incurring additional fees if we liquidate this before the original hold date. For this, you have to pay a funding at the perpetual section. As we can see above, there is a countdown that is set back every 8 hours. When this countdown has expired, the specific amount will be divided from your futures wallet. As I said, you don't have this disadvantage with quarterly trading, but neither do you on the entire spot markets. If you close your positions shortly before the end of the countdown, you will not have to pay any funding fees. This is a very popular variant for day trading with levers. As I said, because you usually have a maximum of leverage on the spot markets, you can expect this funding fee in the futures area. But like this fee, in my opinion, Binance is the cheapest trading provider there is anyway, as I said. Via the first link that you can find below, you can secure yourself another 10% commission discount. How do we even sell our cryptocurrencies on Binance? This is also asked a lot, as surprisingly few people know how to sell their positions again. To do this, you have to enter your cryptocurrency on the standard Binance site, the normal homepage, exactly as if you wanted to buy them. I just enter ADA here. Here of course comes the first turning point. In which market do you want to trade or sell your position? Since there is the spot market and the futures area. In that case, I just go to the futures market. If you have your position on the spot market, you can simply choose your desired currency on the spot markets. Of course, you also can check your portfolio and click on your wished cryptocurrency trade to get there. When we are at the chart for our cryptocurrency that we want to sell, we already have our window to our position down here. Here we can simply click the close all positions button to close each individual trade. Or you can alternatively click on the market button to close each one individually. Then you will also find the possibility to set a take profit or stop loss by limit. For this you can enter your desired amount, the rest will be done automatically. In the order history or trade history up, here you can see exactly how much fees you had to pay or how much profit you made. I hope I was able to help you, and I would be very happy about a like or subscription. If you have any questions at all, just get in touch in the comments below.